Good evening, everybody. My name is Aline Merlijft, and I'm the co-founder of Citizen Lab, a citizen sourcing platform for cities. So nowadays, we have the citizens, on one hand, using digital networks for communicating with each other. They're all connected over networks, but they're not communicating with their governments over digital networks. And they have ideas on how to improve their city. And then on the other hand, you have cities, city governments, who have projects, topics working on, but they are looking for input and feedback from citizens. They are organizing participation events, but these events are mainly offline, and they are always focused or targeting the same people. So that's why we've built Citizen Lab, a citizen sourcing platform. So on one hand, citizens can post ideas on how to improve their city, and on the other hand, the city governments, they can get input and feedback from their citizens. So in this way, we'd like to tap into the collective intelligence in cities. So how does it work exactly? The city is our client. They customize the platform in terms of design and in terms of structure. So they choose on which topics and projects they want to work on. And then citizens, they come online and they can post ideas and they can up or downvote their preferred solutions and vote on other proposals. Our business model, we're a SaaS startup. We're selling our software to city governments via yearly or monthly packages. Where are we right now? We're currently, we sold our solution to 5 paying cities already. Today, I gave a press conference in Hasselt, and there we're going to start with the co-creation of the city park. So their citizens will be able to post ideas on how they like to park to look like. The market. We're in the business-to-government market. The government technology market in general is growing very rapidly, and the smart city market as well. And we're part of that smart city market. More specifically, we're part of the smart governments market, and that market is estimated at 3.15 billion euros globally in 2020. Our competition. Direct competitors are mainly based in the US, so there are similar citizen sourcing platforms there. We have a European focus. We already support more than 20 languages on the platform, so that's how we want to scale in Europe. And on the product sides, we work with gamification, so that will be our competitive advantage, since citizens have a personal score on the platform, and that score will increase when other citizens like or dislike. No, not dislike, but like their ideas or comments. The team, I'm Aline, I'm the co-founder, and Wietse is my co-founder. He's currently studying here at ULB, but he turned himself into a developer, so he developed our MVP. I'm more on the business development side, and then we have Stavros working with us on the product as well. We're supported by iMinds in the iStart Lite program, and we're also incubated by Startit. These are the milestones we've reached so far. So we build our MVP, we have an extra co-founder, we currently launched our first pilot project in Hasselt. In the next months, we'll focus on making these first projects in cities a success, and we'll also more elaborate on the gamification feature. What are we looking for? We're looking for smart money, 150K. We're looking for people with experience in our market, so it means business to government market, or people with experience in building a community online. We'll use it for expanding our team. We'll look for a front-end developer and a sales team to be able to tackle the Wallonian market and the Netherlands at first. And yeah, that's it. So if you'd like to help us shaping digital citizen participation, come talk to me.
Thank you, Aline.